الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم ما بعد. It's imperative that we adhere to the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and we avoid sectarianism. And sectarianism is a very dangerous thing that is a phenomenon that has overrun the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And this is not something new, in fact. Unfortunately, and we know the ahadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the many hadith in which he relates to us that the ummah would break and divide into groups and sects, and all of them would be in the fire except for one, kama qala nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And so it's imperative for us to take the advice of ahl al-ilm, of the people of knowledge. So let's hear what our Shaykh, Shaykh Ibrahim ibn Amir al-Rahili, hafidhallahu ta'ala, says in his book Mawqif Ahl-Sunnah wal-Jama'ah in relation to this phenomenon. قال الشيخ وكما كان السلف يحذرون ذلك تحذير البالغ من خطورة الانتساب إلى غير الإسلام والسنة نجدهم يكرنون القول بالعمل مثبتين ذلك في حياتهم في عدم رضائهم أن ينسبون لغير الإسلام وغير رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. The Shaykh said, and as the Salaf, the pious predecessors, used to warn a very severe warning against the dangers of associating oneself to other than Islam or associating oneself to other than the Sunnah, or considering oneself a part of other than Islam or other than the Sunnah. We see that the Salaf used to compare their statements with actions. They used to weigh their statements and actions. And they would practice that in their lives. And they were not satisfied and were displeased with associating with other than Islam, or than other than the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. كما جاء عن ابن عباس رضي الله تعالى عنهما أنه قال قال لي معاوية رحمة الله عليه أنت على ملة علي رحمة الله عليه قلت لا ولا على ملة عثمان أنا على ملة رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. So then the Shaykh brought a very beautiful athar of the Salaf رضي الله تعالى عنهم أجمعين, in which it was narrated on Ibn Abbas رضي الله تعالى عنهما that he said that Muawiya رضي الله تعالى عنه said to him, are you on the religion of Ali? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be pleased with him. He said, no, nor am I on the religion of Uthman. Rather, I am on the religion of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then the Shaykh went on to say, حفظ الله تعالى, وَإِنَّ لِلْمُسْلِمِينَ الْيَوْمِ لِأُسْوَةٍ حَسَنًا فِي حَرْسِ هَؤُلَاءِ الرِّجَالِ عَلَى دِينِهِمْ وَخَشِيَتِهِمْ عَلَى أَنفُسِهِمْ مِنَ الْفِتْنَةِ. He said, and then for the Muslims in this day, there is a beautiful example in the Salaf, in their strict adherence to their religion and their fear upon themselves, their fearfulness of fitna, of discord and disharmony in trials. في انتسابي إلى غير رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من الرجال. And also they were fearful and avoided associating themselves to any men other than the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. حتى ولو كان هذا الانتساب إلى واحد من كبار أصحاب النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, even if that association towards one of the major companions of the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم وأحد خلفائه الراشدين, or one of his one of the rightly guided Khalifat, الذين أخبر أنهم على حق والهدى وأمر باتباع سنتهم والاتداء بهديهم, فالناظر ابن عباس وسائر السلف الأمة الصالح ما أفقهم بدينهم وما أشد تمسكهم به رضوان الله عليهم أجمعين. Then the Shaykh went on to say, so that the Salaf, they avoided associating themselves, you know, making a group as if they are the followers of Ali, or they're the followers of Ibn Mas'ud, or they're the followers of Uthman, or the followers of even the major scholars from amongst the Sahaba, radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in. Even as they were mentioned in ahadith about their fadl, about that they were on the truth and that they were on guidance. And even though the Prophet ﷺ commanded us to follow their path, their sunnah, and their guidance, Ibn Abbas and the rest of the Salaf of this Ummah had a great understanding of the religion, and they were the most adherent in adhering to the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. May Allah be pleased with all of them. This was the statement of our Shaykh Hafidhullah Ta'ala, which was highlighting the importance of avoiding associating ourselves to names and groups and individuals, because everyone can make a mistake. So we don't say we're the followers of Shaykh Fulan. No, we say we take from Shaykh Fulan as long as he is on the haq, as long as he is upon the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he's calling to the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is what we're ordered to follow. We're going to be asked in our graves about who? About Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Man rabbuk, man ma deenuk, wa man nabiyuk sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We're going to be asked about who is your Lord, and what is your religion, and who is your Prophet? And your Prophet is who? It's Muhammad salawatu rabbi wa salamu alayhi. This is who we're ordered to follow. This is the only one we can blindly follow. And I ask Allah the Almighty to protect us from hizbiyah and from associating ourselves with groups and from blindly following anyone, and especially following anyone in their mistakes. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad.